this is where we really prepare. Riot Act, out here we show no fear. Riot Act, time to protect our communities. Riot Act, real criminals get immunity. Riot Act, eye for an eye, so yo, who want it?
Prošli Dallasu, zvetem največjem mestu v Združenih državah Amerike, kjer domuje slavni fikšaški ranger Chuck Norris. Tukaj pa bo naša pozornost usmerjena v nekaj drugega, in sicer dogodek quakecon 2008, ki se te dni odvija v tem teksaškem mestu. Quakecon pa ni le navaden dogodek, temveč je eden najbolj tradicionalnih dogodkov v e-športu nasploh. Letos poteka že 13. in tudi tokrat bo poleg turnirjev organiziran še sejemski del in jo. Še najpomembnejše pa je to, da bo letos nastopala ekipa Mamut, za katero bo igralo tudi nekaj Slovencev. Za začetek smo spregovorili nekaj besed z Jakcom in poglejmo si, kaj je imel zapovedati.
Torej, Jakec, začetek bi te prosil, če lahko na hiter, na kratko in jedrnato, ampak vseeno dosti razločno. Torej, nekako razložiš, kaj sploh je poanta igre, kaj je kvor sami tudi, ker v bistvu veliko Slovencev ne ve, kakšna igra je to sploh.
Ja, kaj kvor se je timska igra, pač imaš, igra se 6-6, pač uporablja se različne te poklice, imaš štiri različne poklice, kot so recimo soldier, ki lahko uporablja take rocket launcher, pač teža orožja, ker jih pač navadni druge klase ne more uporabljati. Ne. Potem imaš medijega, ki lahko zdravo ljudi, potem imaš še neka field-opa, ki pač daje amo, pa take stvari, pa inženirja, ki postavlja mine, pa še pač neka court-opa, ki je lahko sniper, pa take stvari. In pač igra se igra na objektive, pač imaš mapo, na kateri moš narediti nek objektiv v določenem času in hitrejši čas narediš, boljše za tebe, ker pa moš ta čas tudi obraniti. To je poanta celo špika.
Okay. To je tvoj tretji quakecon. Na dveh si bil vsi odkorakal kot zmagovalec. Na tretjem... Oh, fuck. Joj! Zakaj? Včasih sem bil nupa, ne? Zdaj nisem več, kao. Spet smo na quakeconu. To je tvoj že tretji. In dvakrat si slavil. Kako misliš, da bo tokrat?
Ja, kaže zelo dobro, ne. Upam, da bomo še tretjič zmagali sicer. Zdaj dosegali smo že svoj cilj, smo v top 3 trenutno. Ne. Zdaj, če bomo zmagali, toliko boljš, pak cilje dosežem.
Na letošnjem quakeconu zastopaš ekipo Mamut. Kako ste se zbrali in kako ste sploh prišli na to idejo, da bi odpotovali v Ameriko in kdo vas je sponzoriral?
Ja, ker pač nismo dobili neke podpore iz Dignitasa, smo pač videl, da imamo neke šanse, da nas sponzorira pač ekipa, pač sponzor mamut.si, a ne. In pač je krater kar dober, a ne. In zdaj smo pač probali vzeti čim več Dignitas igralcev sabo, a ne. Tako da imamo pač več šans, da zmagamo.
Okay. Ko ste se pa pripravljali za to tekmovanje? Kaj posebej ali samo prek neta?
Nač posebej. Igral sem prek interneta, sicer takve kurse dokaj se ne igra več to, tako da je ne. 5 klanov je še, kar igrajo aktivno, pa še telne vsak dan, tako da v bistvu zadnje 3 tedne smo malo več igrali, tolo, pa to ni bo nekaj kakšnih posebnih prav.
In kaj bo v prihodnosti, kakšne načrte imate?
Zdaj trenutno še ne vemo čist točen, probali bomo iti na čim več članov, čim večjih različnih igrah, a ne? Probali se bom pač malo bolj razviti, pa take stvari.
My third quakecon. About 2 months before this event, we started to reform our old Dignitas lineup, but Hugo couldn't make it, so we recruited Darkman, we also got Mamut.si as our sponsor for this trip. So I'm really happy that they picked us up,
was a lot of fun. Quakecon 2008. It was a really nice event. We did a lot of stuff outside of the tournament, going to the city, visiting some places. In the tournament, we did very well. We won the tournament. It was really nice. It went easier than expected, much easier than last year, Quakecon 2007.
Pričakovanja pred Quakeconom niso bila nekakšna posebna, glede na to, da nismo trenirali skor nič, glede na to, da ni bilo nekako planov. Zdaj, po temu, ker smo se prej uvrstili med top 3, smo že vejali, da pač nekaj smo že dosegali. Zdaj, pa enkrat, ko smo enkrat zmagali, je bilo to res nekaj nevretenega, ker pač glede na to, da smo igrali oziroma zastopali nek slovenski klan in v bistvu zdaj to neka ful huda zmaga, glede na to, da je bilo pač, da smo zastopali slovenski klan in kaj bo vem, to je spet neka nova izkušnja za me. Trikrat sem bil v Ameriki, trikrat sem zmagal. Tako mislim, glede na to, da smo zmagali dokaj lahko, tega niti nismo pričakovali.
Coming into this tournament, I think we were like the underdogs because we didn't play officials for a long time and Companyet was with same lineup and the American teams were here before last year. So everyone knew the game and they knew our game style. So we tried to put in as much practice as possible to get back in shape. And it turned out to be enough because we took first place and $8,000. The first match we had was kind of easy. We didn't underestimate our opponents. We played as usual. It was against TLP, if I'm not mistaken. So after that, we had some random Americans, and still team decimated. We didn't have any good opponents. So going into that, we checked our tactics, made sure everything is okay, and took it 4-0. We were really happy, and decimated fell into the loser bracket. We thought that they will beat Companyet, but it turned out otherwise. Companyet took it 4-2, so we had to face them in the finals. And yeah, we knew they were a strong European team. And just talked and said that everything's okay, we take it relaxed, and went into the final with clear head. The final started, I think our team was a bit nervous because we didn't practice once since 2 months. We only got practice against Vicious and Evil, Designate, Four Kings and so on. I think some of the teams kind of boycotted us because they knew we will turn up to be very strong. So yeah, we didn't underestimate Compa, but the first map was sure, and we set a time of 8 minutes. We were really confident that this is enough, but Compa did a comeback. They took first stage in 2 minutes, and this really surprised us, so we were kind of panicking in second and third defense. Last minute was really intense, but we pulled it through. So second map, we were really confident and took it with ease.
For me personally, I don't quite know. I mean, all this gaming professional stuff and esports, whatever, I don't really see any future in this. Just money being pumped in and nothing really coming out of it. Only the top players can really make a living or something. If you want to call it professional gaming or that, or something like that, there is only like 3 or 5 players or something who can make a living. Out of the first place shooter players, the RTS players, of course, in Korea and China and so on. Of course, they can make a living as well, but I'm talking about FPS gaming.
How about your
for me personally, I don't know, we'll see. Maybe next year, I'll be here again, I don't know. RTCW 2, Wolfenstein, sorry. Maybe, who knows. But we'll see how it goes. But I hope I can play, keep playing for Team Mamut, you know. We'll see how it goes.
My future in gaming, hopefully it will be in Mamut, because they provide so good support. And I think I will play Call of Duty 5, maybe, if it's good and people start playing it. Then there is Wolfenstein, the new Wolfenstein. Then there is Battlefield 3. I'll see which game is the most popular, which has the most money, which is the best, and I'll play that game.
Well, you have anything else to add?
Yes, big thanks to Lightman, Darkman, who made this possible.
Upam, da bomo ta Mamut klan razbil v nekaj velikega, pač probal bom pač pomagati tukaj v tej organizaciji, če bo do tega prišlo. Pač vidim se kot nek manager trenutno, probal bom tudi še kaj igrati, če bo kaj cajta za to ostalo. Trenutno se bom bolj posvetil študiju, bomo pa videl, kakšna bo prihodnost. Če bo sreča, se vrnem v drug let, pa še enkrat zmagam. To je pa to.
Znaš, kjer dodati, kako bolje?
Hvala Mamut.si ekipi, da je pač sponzorirala nas, da smo pač lahko šli na Quakecon.